insects. No. Outside, cocaine white, but he look like Gentiles. Gentiles. Emotional, 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 emotional. What's up, guys? Welcome back. Today I will be finally, hopefully, installing the carbon fiber with leather steering wheel. I am trying to do this before tonight's meet. Still gotta touch up some spots that Jason missed as he was trying to help me finish. I don't think I'm gonna be doing the side skirts. I'm kind of over it. That's how the car looks right now. Again, I'm gonna try and install the steering wheel before the meet tonight. So I'm gonna watch some videos and then try and figure this thing out and we'll come back to it. This is my current wheel right now. It's peeling really, really bad at the top. And just this first year, because mine's a 2015, the steering wheel was not the best quality. It's like this shiny fake leather. I know the steering wheels are a lot better now, but we will be moving on to that bad boy. So you'll need a ratchet to go ahead and disconnect ground, the negative, and then make sure when you do loosen it, you're gonna have to use a little flathead and kind of separate the connector. So mine was a little crusty, so I had to brush it off first. So you might have to do the same thing. And then it finally, I just kind of pried it off and I was able to get it off. Make sure you don't let it touch the battery again. So I do have it wrapped on a towel. Guys, for this part, you will need a longer flathead. It doesn't really need to be too long, but you've got this hole here. There's three prongs that are actually holding in your airbag. You really need to like tuck your head under, use a flashlight to get in there. Right now it's getting late, so I definitely needed the flashlight. There's also another hole just like this one on the left side, and then there's one directly on the bottom of the steering wheel. So we were able to get all three off, and now I can gently remove my airbag, and then I'll show you which connectors to disconnect in just a bit. All right, so guys, in order to remove the airbag or disconnect it, you're gonna get a flathead and just pry up on these little yellow tabs here, and it should come right up. Again, you just have to flick these up, these tabs just pretty high up. Just make sure they're pretty loose. And then you gotta kind of play with these and pop it right off. So now the airbag is fully disconnected. And then next, my battery is disconnected. So make sure you do that before you do this. You're gonna disconnect the airbag harness here. It's connected to the battery. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pull that right out. Okay, and then once you disconnect the harness, then you can go ahead and disconnect the clock spring. There's like a little metal tab here. And you just push that down, disconnect just like that. And now your whole airbag is successfully disconnected. All right, so got this nut loose. Man, that shit was torqued down. It's a 17 millimeter. Loosened it just enough. Make sure you don't take off the bolt all the way off, because getting the steering wheel is so hard. When you finally get it off, you don't want to like have this come swinging right back at you. So leave the nut on until you finally wiggle it loose, and it should be able to pop out like that. I'm gonna go ahead and loosen this. Okay. Steering wheel is finally off. You just need a Phillips to remove this little screw that was right here. Gonna go ahead and put that off to the side, save it. Then what you want to do is flip it over. It's gonna be like a little orange clip here. Just gonna push that out, and then this whole backing should come off. Okay, and if it's not coming off right away, it's because there are some clips that are actually holding this harness in place. And there you go, the whole part in the back is off. And then on the back side here, there's three little Phillips screwdrivers, or screws, sorry. And gonna go ahead and take all these out. Again, gonna save those. Remove that piece. And last one over here. And these are the screws that are holding in the little trim pieces. Flip it over, and then we'll be able to remove this piece here. I'm gonna add that to the new steering wheel, and then
same thing. Go ahead and take these pieces out. Just gotta wiggle it back and forth. And the trim pieces are off. Now we also wanna save these clips because this is what's gonna hold in the actual airbag. And there's one there. There's one back here. So you can use a flathead for that one. And then you got one on the bottom here. The other one. Okay, got that one out. All right, and that's the clips. And now we are officially done with this cheap OEM wheel. So dirty, so cheap. So I'm super hyped to put the new one on. So let's get to that. Okay, and so we transferred over the original clips here. Or to hold the airbag in place. We reconnected everything, tightened down the bolt, nice and solid. Make sure when you're putting it back that it kind of looks similar to the position of the steering wheel before it went into the lock position. I'm gonna go ahead and reconnect these. Push down the tabs. And we're gonna reconnect the clock spring here. That is on everything. Make sure all your connections are in, the harness is connected, and go ahead and pop this sucker back in. And there you guys have it. The steering wheel is completed. Took a little while just to kind of reach certain, like the clips and all that, but overall this looks really nice. Can't wait to see it in the daylight. Super hyped on it. It's got grooves on the back at the top for your fingers, and then it's much thicker than the old OEM wheel that I had, and even on the bottom there's contours for your fingers here. Just overall really good quality. Super hyped on it, and shout out to my girlfriend because she got it for me as a early Christmas present. So it's something I've been begging her for a while now. Super hyped on it. Feels really, really good. And more carbon fiber that I will be in love with. So thank you again, and thanks for tuning in. And if you guys have any questions, comment in the video, and also subscribe and like the video. Help your boy out, please. But if you guys liked it, for sure, try to let me know. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.
Down right now, put me in the mood. I'm talking about dark.